Our next entertainer joins us tonight. She's easily one of the most popular performers of modern times, and she's also one of the busiest, but she always loves coming home to the Grand Ole Opry. So let's join Joe Elmore in the video room with superstar and Opry member Barbara Mandrell.
Well, thank you a lot, Keith, and Barbara, thank you so much for coming home backstage at the Grand Ole Opry.
Well, you said it very, very correctly. This is my home for many years, and it always feels so wonderful.
You know, I love to read that story about how several years ago, when you and Ken just got married, I believe, and you'd taken a break from show business for a while, you came here with your father, I believe, saw the Opry and decided, well, you had to get back on the stage. Is that right? Is that a true story?
Yes, almost. I had just flat out retired at the ripe old age of 18. And I'd already been in country music for about 9 years. And I wanted to only be Mrs. Kenneth Dudney. And he was a Navy pilot, and when he was sent overseas, my family had moved here to Tennessee. And so Daddy and I went to the Grand Ole Opry when it was back at the old Ryman, and it was in the balcony. And I was watching, and I just said, I can do this. I want to do this. And I said, will you manage me? And Daddy said that he would, and he said he was willing to bet his last penny on me, and he almost did, too.
Yeah. Well, it's a team that worked. You two did team up, and the success story is already well known quite a bit. I think it's appropriate that we're in this video room because this is the kind of place you're going to be spending some time in, I guess, in the next few days. Barbara has a new special that's going to be taped next Wednesday here at the Opry House.
Yes.
And you'll spend a lot of time here in the next few days. And well, I'd like for you to tell me about it. It's a tribute to country music with you and Johnny Cash.
Yes, I'm so thrilled to pieces that I'm going to be able to co-host with Johnny Cash, because Johnny Cash was the one that gave me my first job touring in my whole life ever when I was 13, and I love him very much. At any rate, we have 75 artists on this show that evening, and it's an all-star salute to country music, and it is done on the stage of the Grand Ole Opry. It's a two-hour special on TNN. We'll air the evening of March 7th, and that's at 8 o'clock Central. And it's quite a marvelous way to celebrate this 7th anniversary of having TNN. I'm not being silly, and I probably should hush, I'm too honest, but we live out in the woods in our log house, and we bought a satellite. We thought in the long run, pardon me, but that'd be cheaper than paying for cable. At any rate, my husband wanted the one satellite. I said, I want two satellites because I want to be able, if you or the kids are watching something else, I want to be able to watch TNN anytime I want. So we bought one satellite just so that I could watch TNN whenever I choose to, and that's almost all the time. So I'm quite honored to be a part of this TNN special that, as I said, will air March 7th. And You Name It is on that show. It's just, I'm thrilled.
I think you said it in a nutshell, You Name It. We don't have time to go through the list of people that are going to be on that show. The stars, but who are some of the others that are going to be on?
You're going to make a lot of people mad at me, but there's 75 people, and this is just off the top of my head. Alabama, Randy Travis, Ricky Van Shelton, Clint Black, Ann Murray, Jeannie C. Riley, Jeannie Pruitt, Patti Loveless, Jeannie Seeley, Connie Smith, and there's zillions of them that are...
A few pretty big names, a little bit of talent.
Campbell and Roy Clark. It goes on and on. It goes on and on.
The list goes on, as they say.
Please watch. Please watch.
Oh, gosh.
And also, may I plug something else that TNN is doing?
You may.
Not only for me, but for Louise Mandrell and Erlene Mandrell. They bought all of our Barbara Mandrell and the Mandrell Sisters series. And the evening of March 31st, that Saturday night, is the first Saturday night that they begin to air us every Saturday night. And I'm very pleased.
That's going to be really exciting. That was a big hit series, a return to the family variety show formats, if you will. And I know a lot of people are looking forward to seeing that. And there are a lot of great guests that were on those shows. I think Gilley was on one I saw. Now I'm losing the list of names, too. But
it was, I think, the thing I missed the most when we were on every week, little children, and I do mean little ones, even toddlers, would see me, and they'd say, Barbara Mandrell, you know, never Miss Mandrell or never Barbara, it was always Barbara Mandrell, and they'd grab me by the leg or hug me. I felt kind of like Captain Kangaroo must feel or something. I loved it when the little children just treated us so dearly, so I look forward to that happening again. It's very much for all ages, that series, and I really hope you'll watch that on TNN.
It was definitely a landmark show, a family series. As you said, you did comedy skits that, yes, that were really funny, and you did lots of music and dancing and, you know, the kind of stuff we don't get to see enough of on television.
I love variety very much, and I think TNN is so very wise for doing so much of it and affording all of us that are fans. I think I'm the biggest fan of music and entertainment that there is. They afford us the opportunity to do that every day, to watch variety, and I like that.
Looking forward to that. As if that weren't enough, are there any other projects in the works you want to talk about?
February. This is February. Yes.
Yes.
Yes. I spend about a week in a couple of weeks working. My editor and my co-writer for my autobiography are coming here. I'm not quite happy with the last chapter yet, and I'm going to get some expert advice on it. And I have to locate 50 pictures that they can choose from for the book, and that's been quite a project, long in the works, and I've worked very hard on it. My second draft, I was laying in our tent camping. We love to camp, and I had the little lantern and working on my second draft. I mean, you know, but whatever it takes, and. It's due out in fall for a fall release, so I look forward to that book happening.
Wow, that must have been a painstaking process to get it just right, and you have to do that. There's only one take on a book like that.
Yes, it is, and it's very serious and important to me for it to be my real life. And so not only has God blessed me with letting me be on many mountaintops in my life, but I've also been down in the valley many times, and it's hard to relive the sad and the tragic times, but I think that's so very important for anyone to know that even with all the glitter and the wonderful things that you afford us in show business, the applause and the love and all the lights and the great things and the sparkly clothes, we are just people, and I think it's a very important thing for people to know that.
Well, you're going to be on stage with one of your favorite people, Mr. Acuff.
Yes.
He always hosts the show, I think, when you're on, and I think that's a great team.
That's my request always. I love Mr. Acuff so very, very much. It just excites me a lot. There's no sweeter man in this world, and handsome, and the most beautiful hair, and he just has done so much. He truly is the king of country music. He always will be.
Well, you're a queen, too.
Thank
We're
you.
Glad to have you.
Queenie. As the Statlers say, I don't deserve to ever be queen of, but I could be Queenie.
Or a princess, perhaps.
Thank you, Jim.
Keith, from the video room to the stage of the Grand Ole Opry, Miss Barbara Mandrell, in just a few minutes.
Well, in just a few seconds, Barbara Mandrell is going to take the stage with all the due rights. Here's Roy Acuff to introduce her.
Okay. I'm going to bring in one of my favorites in the entertainment world now, and I think you will agree that she's just as fine as they come when it comes to entertaining. I can remember when she had her show on the network here a few years ago, and they were very popular, and she's still very popular in everything that she does. She's just a loved girl and well-known throughout our country, and in our music, they just don't come any better. She was born in Houston, Texas, and reared up out in California, and Herbie Mandrell brought up a whole family of them, and they are all lovely people, and we're just glad that she is here with us this evening. You'll make her welcome. She'll possibly entertain you much better than I can. Would you make welcome, please, Miss Barbara Mandrell? Where are you at, Barbara? So over here. Uh-huh. You come in on the other side.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Sitting on the front porch, rain is pouring down. The roots come on the radio. There's trouble all around, but that's the way it's always been. Jobs are skills down at the factory. I thank the good Lord I've got you in times like these. In times like these, when it's easy to get down, you're my inspiration, my solid ground.
times like these. In times like these, baby. In times like these.
Another one?
We're going to have another one.
All right. Here's what I want to do. Come here, Mr. Acuff.
I sit here. I took care of your flowers. I laid them on the piano.
They're mine, though. They're not yours.
I know it.
Come sit right here for me.
You want me to sit there?
Yes, sir.
Well, they do it.
This man, and my husband knows it, so it's okay. This man stole my heart. Almost 18 years ago.
Stole your heart?
Yes, sir.
Why don't you tell me?
When you made me a member of the Grand Ole Opry.
Yeah.
You and Mr. Bud Wendell that night.
Yeah.
And I have a brand new album out now called Morning Sun. At least it's coming out very soon. And there's a song on that album that took an old pop song that I love the words to it. And what I did it Western Swing, and I know you like Western Swing music, too. Would it be all right with you if I sang it to you? You'd be my inspiration. Oh, thank you. Okay, fellas. Eat your heart out, girls. You look so handsome tonight.
It's not the pale moon that excites me, that thrills and delights me. Oh, no. It's just the nearness of you. It isn't your sweet conversation that brings this sensation. Oh no. It's just the nearness of you. When you're in my arms and I feel you so close to me, soft lights to enchant me, if you'll only grant me the right to hold you ever so tight and to feel in the night. Oh, my heart.
May I have this dance?
So close to me, all my wildest dreams come true. I need no soft lights to enchant me, if you'd only grant me the right to hold you ever so tight.
Mr. Roy Acuff, the king of country music.
That's the first dance step I've taken in 50 years.
Well, I have to tell you, ladies, it felt good and it sure looked good, didn't it? Oh, yes.
Well, I wish, have we got time? Can't you do another short song or something?
I just want to say this with all my heart. Mr. Acuff and I have played softball together 2 or 3 times. I like the dancing even better.
I like that. I do too.
And I know you have a lot of show here tonight. You don't want me to do another, but I sure thank you very, very much.
You're a sweet girl.
You thrill me so.
Barbara Mandrell. You heard it. too, Becky. Thank you all. Come back and dance with me again, Barbara. Come back sometime and dance with me, Barbara. I feel 20 years younger. Better not act it, though, or I'll fall dead up here.